Dear students, welcome to my channel. Topic is part of speech tag part 1. This is a basic video on part of speech tag concept. Let us start. What is mean by part of speech tag or POS? It is a syntactic category or class of any word in natural language sentence. For example, they comes in the category of noun, verb, adjective, adverb, etc. For example, the example is given, our dog chased a brown cat away from the home. Now what is we required to do in the POS category? For every word we have to determine its POS category. For example, our belongs to the pronoun, a and the is determiner, dog, cat, home, they are the nouns, brown is adjective, chased is a verb but in past tense, away is adverb and from is preposition. So we require to automatically do the processing that whenever the sentence is given, we require to separate its part of speech tag. POS tagging problem. Problem is to identify what is the actual category for each of the word. Given a text of English, identify the part of speech of each word. For example, just take another statement. The boy put the toys in the bag. Now here, POS category in a word. The words like boys, toys and bag will come under the category of noun, put will be verb, in will be the preposition and the will be determiner. POS tag tells us more information about the word and its overall role in the sentence. POS tag of word also tells some information about its neighboring words also. Nouns are generally preceded by adjective and or determiner. For example, the girl, an ant and some boy. Identifying the POS tags is an important initial step for more complex downstream of the NLP task, such as parsing, information extraction, sentiment analysis and machine translation. POS tags can be broadly categorized into two categories. First is a closed class and second is open class. Closed class, relatively fixed set of words that is limited in number. Addition of new closed words is very rare. Mostly they are functional to tie the concept of sentence together. For example, preposition, determiners, pronouns and connectives are come under the category of closed class. Open class cannot associate a fixed set of words. New records can be frequently encountered with such POS tags. Mostly they are the content bearing, that is they refer to the object, action and features in the world. Addition of new open words is very frequent. For example, noun. So every day we can get the new noun, that is the name of the person or name of the thing. So name, nouns, verb, adjective, adverb, they comes under the category of open class. Now when we see the part of speech tag, then it has a level that how much detail we want to specify that particular category. Decision of is to take a very coarse grain level or to go to the more fine grain level. So depending on our application, we can decide this level. So if particular application may require the coarse and some may require a very fine part of speech tagging. In coarse grain level, we can identify a word as a noun, but we can't tell whether it's singular noun or plural noun. So our scope is up to only identify the noun, but not its a detailed category. In fine grain level, we can give grammatical details of the word. For example, verb belong to the past tense, future or present, whether it is used with the third singular, third non-singular person. In very fine grain level, too many parts of speech tag also leads to the confusion because we require to write down the programming in such way to identify the part of speech tag in a detailed manner. Now variety types of POS tag set are available. The famous are brown corpus tag set, in which it contains 87 tags, UPenn tree bank tag set 45 tags and C7 tag set 146 tags. So now generally in NLP application, PenN tree bank is very popular, which includes 45 tags and they are very easy, and with these 45 tags we generally find out most of the category of the part of speech tag of the word. And C7 is in very much detail because they are giving for the, or they are going for the fine detail. PenN tree bank, it is also referred as PTB, very popular part of speech tag set, which is designed by the University of Pennsylvania. It is also called PenN tree bank PTB. It contains 45 part of speech tags, fairly standardized for English. Popular NLP tools such as Stanford Core NLP Specie use this tag set. Apostrophes are small and compact with 2 to 4 capital characters. Now we will see some important tags which are generally used in NLP. Noun types. For example, NN, that is singular common noun. Examples are woman, orange, table. They comes under the category of noun, but it is of singular noun. Plural common noun. Examples are women, oranges, tables, and that is nothing but they are plural in nature. Singular proper noun. For example, Priya, Zenith, Jack. They comes under the category of proper noun, but they are singular. Plural proper noun. Example, Indians, Americans. Now variety types of verbs are there. VB is nothing but the base form of verb. For example, walk, play, eat, read. VBD is nothing but past tense. Walk, played, ate and read. VBN, past participle of a verb. Walk, played, eaten, read. VBG, gerund form of verb. For example, when we add the ing, it can be act as a gerund form. So fishing is we can act as a verb also and act as a noun also. Fishing, walking, reading, that is nothing but the gerund form of verb. VBZ and VBP, they are used to distinguish between the third person and non-third person. So VBZ is used for third person verb on present tense. For example, walks, plays, eats. And VBP is for non-third person. For example, walk, play, eat, read, am, are. And MD is nothing but modal verb. They are nothing but can, may, should, might. So they comes under the category of modal verb. Adjective and adverb types. JJ is adjective, like intelligent, small, fast. Comparative adjective, when there is a comparison, better, smaller, faster. Superlative, that is the topmost, best, smallest, fastest. Similarly, in adverb also categories are there. Adverb are denoted by RB. For example, back, behind, fast, slow. Comparative adverb, slower and faster. Superlative adverb, like slowest and fastest. Pronoun determinant preposition type. PRP is pronoun. For example, he, she, they, I, we. When we are using the possessive, then that is nothing but his, her, yours, and it is denoted by PRP followed by the dollar sign. POS is nothing but the possessive marker. So it is used with the proper noun. India's, Asians. DT is determiner. So A and the is nothing but comes under the category of determiner. CCR, coordinating conjunction, that is the connecting words like and, or, also, but. Preposition, in, under, of, from, with. Cardinal number, when it is represented in sentence that the number form either in your number or either in English format, that is 22. So this is the all 45 tags are there. So I have mentioned all the important tags that you have to remember for the NLP task. For example, statement is I am girl. Now how we will, or our program should categorize these four words into the different tagging. I belongs to the pronoun. Am belong to the non-third person verb on present tense. A is determiner. Girl is a singular common noun. Kavya is an intelligent girl. So from the word you can easily find out that Kavya belongs to the singular proper noun. Is VBZD, or it is also called as auxiliary verb, that is third person verb on present tense. A is determiner. Intelligent is adjective and girl is again single common noun. She plays tennis. Now here she is pronoun. Plays is nothing but the third person verb, that's why it is VBZ. Tennis is again noun. And they play football. Here they belongs to the pronoun category. Play here comes as a VPP, as non-third person verb on a present tense, and football is again singular common noun. So we should be able to identify the category, that is not in detail, but roughly we should be able to categorize the past tense statement. And now for something completely different. Now here and is nothing but coordinating conjunction. Now is nothing but adverb. For is preposition. Something is singular common noun. Completely is adverb and different is adjective. So whatever example I have covered, they are very straightforward and it is very easy, because for most of the word there is only one part of speech tag, but in reality this is not the situation. For example, just see this example. They refuse to permit us, and they refuse to permit us to obtain the refuse permit. Now first example, they belongs to the pronoun category. Refused is nothing but non-third person verb in a present tense. To is determiner, permit, now to permit. So now permit here is a verb and PRP is again pronoun. Now they refuse to permit us to obtain the refuse permit. Now if we observe this line, here the permit has a two different part of speech tag, even the word is same. Now again they is nothing but pronoun, refuse is nothing but the non-third person verb, the to is determiner, permit here it acts as a verb, us is again pronoun, to is again determiner. Now obtain is a verb because it is preceded by to, refuse is here noun. And now in the first statement or even in this statement, refuse is first VBP, now it is comes under the category of noun. Permit is under the category of VB, but now it is a category of noun. So that makes difference. So these particular words, they carry the multiple part of speech tag depends on the context. What is the automated pause tagging? It is a process of assigning a pause tag to each word in an input text. Input is our sentence with tokenized words or sentence output from morphological parsing. So when we get the output from morphological parsing, at that time we will get the multiple output for that particular word. Either that word may be act as verb or that word may be act as a noun. And the set of pause tags with us. Output is a pause tag is assigned unambiguously to each word. Now the problem is not so simple because most of the words which comes under the category of open class, they face the issue of ambiguities, difficulties and challenges. A word may have different pause tags. For example, to sort the number, here sort is verb, but when I say bubble sort, sort is noun. Closed class pause tags are not ambiguous, but they are very much fixed and they are generally used for connecting lines, and their frequency is also limited in a statement. Generally, words with open class are more prone to the multiple pause tags. Open class pause tags occur a lot more frequently because open class words are very common in a sentence. So they occur frequently and its tagging depends on its neighboring context, that is previous and future words. Now see the example of ambiguities in pause tagging. The attack was brutal. Now here the attack is comes under the category of noun. King was planning to attack neighboring state. Now to attack, it comes under the verb. Tiger usually attack their prey in a group. Now it is comes under the non-third person because tigers is there. So now same word attack comes into the three ways: noun, then verb, and the verb for the third non-third person. Now take the next example of books. On Sunday I read the two books. So it is books is noun but in plural form. During winter season he books a flight ticket to avail the discount. Now here he is nothing but a third person, so the VBZ is coming, that is a tense in a present tense and it is used with the third person. They will book a flight on Sunday. So here the book is again verb, but it is used with the non-third person, that's why it is a VBP category. Now even determiners are very simple, but still they can occur with a different ambiguities also. For example, I read that book several times, so here that comes as determiner. We thought that you are in a class, so here that belongs to the in category, that is preposition category. We were talking about a village group that had won the first prize in cricket. Now here that is comes under the category of determiner, that is nothing but WH determiner. So in which the whenever the words like which, that comes in connecting words, they comes under the category of WH determiner. Now the word is same but the part of speech tags are different. So that's why the part of speech tagging problem is not simple and the variety types of ways are there to deal with this problem. So in the next video, I am going to discuss the pause tagging ambiguities in detail and also various ways are there to cover the pause ambiguities like hidden Markov model, conditional random fields, the variety types of ways are there. So this is all about the basic of part of speech tagging. Thank you.